React.js mind map, part 4 of 10, repository. Let's create a data repository for the mind map. The repository is the JS object with CRUD methods. The method to create new items. The method to delete items of the mind map. The method to update existing items. And the methods to read item data. To read one item data by ID. And to read a list of items. We're gonna use the browser local storage to save data. The local storage is a key value storage. We will save all the items of the mind map as a string in one key of local storage. The key with the name data. To get the item by ID from the local storage, we get the data stream. Then we pass the stream to a JS array, and then we find in the array the item with the ID. To get a list is much the same as to get an item. We need to get data stream from the local storage. Pass the string to JS array. And then filter the array. To update the item, we need to get it first. So we get the data stream from the local storage. Pass it to the JS array. Find the item with ID in the array. Then we need to set the new value for each property of the item. And finally, save the stringified array of items in the local storage. Let's create a method to add new items. Each item has to have a unique ID. We use local storage for the repository. So a simple count number will do for ID. To get the next unique ID, we just get the biggest ID in the items list. We use mathmax method to get the biggest ID and spread operator. And then get the next number. To save new item, we need to get the data string from the local storage, pass it to a JS array, push the item into the array and save the stringified array in the local storage. It would be more convenient to use one method with name save instead of two methods with names add and update. If an item has an ID, we use the update method. If there's no ID in the item is new, we use the add method. And of course we need the delete method. To delete one item, we just need to remove it from the array. But an item of the mind map can have sub-items. If we delete the item, there is no need for sub-items. The sub-items should be deleted with the item. And sub-items of the sub-items up to the end. So we delete the item with all sub-items in two steps. First we mark the item and its sub-items recursively with deleted property. Next step we remove all marked deleted items from the array. And finally, save the stringified array in the local storage. So we have the layout, icon buttons, screens and the router. We have the data repository. Thank you for watching to the end. Subscribe to our channel and you will learn how to create the home screen with a list of mind maps.